The other thing that induces autophagy, you were mentioning the stress response and oxygen, and it sort of reminded me of exercise and how exercise also induces autophagy. I've seen some studies where in humans, they've looked at muscle, skeletal muscle, and how aerobic exercise and eccentric and concentric exercise all can activate autophagy in skeletal muscle. Does it act, do you know if it activates autophagy in multiple tissues, exercise?
That's something that we have not studied. So it is known that endurance training is particularly efficient in mice to induce autophagy, and that it mediates anti-obesity and anti-diabetic effects that are depending in a way on autophagy induction, because genetic modifications of the process that leads to autophagy induction, its inhibition specifically by exercise, can prevent these anti-diabetic effects.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that the role of the exercise in preventing diabetes was shown to be dependent on autophagy to some degree. That's very interesting. Mm-hmm. So do you think that has to do with in the liver, in the like pancreas, somewhere? I mean, is it known?
Yeah, to know this in detail, it would be necessary to inhibit autophagy specifically in different tissues. Mm-hmm. And to my knowledge, this has not been done yet.
Okay. Mm. So do you think fasting while you're exercising in a fasted state? Now, that's another thing that's, do you think that would be important? Or do we, I mean, I've seen some studies in mice where they claim it is, but mice have a very high metabolism, and so there's a synergy there. Mm. But when you look in humans, it's not so important. So, like, the exercise can still induce autophagy and skeletal muscle in humans even without being in a fasted state. But the question is, like, will you synergize more? And
You can speculate, but we don't know.
I'm giving you a lot of ideas here.